Go. Right.
Here we go. Use the substitution. U equals the square root of x plus 2 to find the exact value of that. Right? Well, are we using that substitution?
You will be able to, and it's nicely blown off.
What we're thinking here, we need to remember when you do substitution, we need to replace the x bits, we also need to replace the dx. So we need to get a relationship between du and dx. So the first thing we're going to have to do with this is
du by dx.
Yeah, find du by dx. But this actually, it strikes me that when we've got the square root here, this is going to be easier if we write this as being u squared is x plus 2. So x is u squared minus 2. That looks like an easier way of doing it. We just have to find a relationship between du and dx. It doesn't matter if we find du by dx or dx by du. Okay, that seems like a reasonable thing to do to start with. I'm not sure where this is going to lead us, but we'll give that a go. And so now, we're going to change the limits over. We've got that when x is minus 1, well, if x is minus 1, that is u equals the square root of 1. So u is 1. And if x is 7, u equals the square root of 7 plus 2. So the square root of 9, so u is 3. So our original integral is the integral now from 1 to 3. And we're going to do some replacements of some things in there. We've got the square root of x plus 2 on the bottom, so that is u down there. We've got x squared on the top. And x squared is u squared minus 2 squared. We've got dx here, so we've got dx. And now, in order to turn it into being dx in terms of u, we're going to have to multiply top and bottom by u. So it's going to be dx by du, du. Is that okay? Does that make sense to everybody as being, we've done the replacements, x squared we replaced with the square of that, root x plus 2 is u, dx, we've written dx by du, du.
What does that equal?
Well, dx by du is 2u.
So
our next line has that being the integral of u squared minus 2 squared over u times 2u du.
Where did you get the dx du du?
Okay. If we're going to change this so it's in terms of u instead of x, then we need to have a du there instead. Now, we can't just swap them because they're not equal to each other. But what we can do is we can multiply the expression by 1. Because that doesn't change it, by 1. You can always multiply by 1. And so I've multiplied dx by du over du. Because du over du is 1.
Okay.
But in writing it in such a way, it gives us dx by du, which is 2u. Now, the u cancels out. There it goes. And I think it makes sense to multiply that bracket. And so we've got, twice u to the 4 minus 4u squared plus 4. Du. Which is now quite a straightforward thing to integrate. It means we've got twice u to the 5 over 5. Minus 4 u cubed over 3 plus 4 u between 1 and 3. And if we put the limits in, we've got 2 lots of, what have we got, 3 to 5. You might want to do this in the calculator. 243. No, it's not. There it is. What? And then this one is it's 36. And then that's 12. And then we're taking away a fifth minus 4/3. That's 4. So we get.
Over 15.
What?
Oh no, I've done it times by 2.
That's what I got.
652 over 15. That's great.
No, 652.
See, the mock scheme says that the answer. I could have just looked at the mock scheme earlier. I can't find the question. It says 652 over 15.
Puppet.